you Brown?
Yes.
I'm Max Swift. How you doing?
I was afraid you wouldn't come.
Your email said you needed help. You want to tell me about it?
I'm afraid someone's trying to kill me. Excuse me.
Pardon me. Should we take a walk? Why don't you tell me a little something about yourself, like what kind of work you do here?
I adapt computer programs to use here at the hospital.
You, under a lot of stress?
This is not something in my head. This is not something that I made up.
Do you live alone?
Yes. And that's another thing. Sometimes it feels like someone's been in my apartment. Nothing I can put my finger on, but a feeling.
What is your social life like? I mean, who are your friends? Is it possible that one of them may be playing a bad joke on you?
I have no social life. I talk to people on my computer, on the net. You know, like chat rooms, bulletin boards, but it's all anonymous. They don't know who I am.
You see, without some idea of who this might be or why they might want to hurt you...
The city's full of crazies. They don't need why.
A close encounter with a lousy driver doesn't always mean a murder attempt.
But that, I know that's what it is. I know it. You have to help me.
I help people with nowhere to turn, no one to help. You have alternatives.
Like what? I have no one.
Like the police department, a private investigator.
And I tell them what? They'll do what you did. They won't listen. If I'm right and you're wrong, I'm as good as dead. Please, Mr. Swift, I don't know why this is happening, and I don't know who's behind it. But I'm scared. Roddy!
Don't use my name. That's not who I am anymore. You know better.
You look good. Distinguished.
You too. Look good.
How's your family?
Look, I don't mean to be rude, but I don't want to talk about myself or you or anything about us. I told you last time we talked, there's too much risk.
Someone tried to kill me.
What happened?
Someone in a car tried to run me over. He was waiting for me, almost like he knew I would be there. I heard the engine, I looked back, and I saw the car coming right at me.
Makes you think it's got anything to do with us, with the past?
I don't know. Maybe it doesn't. But I've spent the last 25 years of my life being anonymous, completely uninvolved with anybody. That's the only thing it could be.
Did you contact TJ?
We have stayed in touch periodically, like we all agreed to do. But I haven't contacted him about this, not yet.
Maybe you should. This guy came into the bookstore a while back. He said he was a grad student doing his doctoral on the politics of the 70s generation. We got to talking. He asked me if I remembered the robbery in 72 at the Commonwealth Bank.
Damn it, Roddy.
It's not my fault. Got a lot of ink. It was logical he might know about it. He wanted to know if I knew any of the radicals involved. It was almost like he was watching for a reaction instead of expecting an answer. I couldn't sleep for a couple of nights, but when he didn't come back, I figured it was nothing.
Nothing? Now he's trying to kill me.
You don't know that.
Why didn't you call me to warn me and TJ? We all agreed anything like that, we'd warn each other.
I just didn't want to deal with it. I figured if there was someone on to me, all I'd do would be to lead them to you and TJ. I still think that.
Well,
good luck.
Yeah, be careful, all right?
So, yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah. Someone tried to kill her, too. Just the other day.
Did you know the guy that was shot?
Not while he was alive.
Oh, how'd this go down?
How'd it go down? One minute the guy's alive, next minute the guy's dead. Gunshot somewhere in between.
So in other words, you can't give us anything. Boy, girl, young, old, man in the moon?
Could have been any of those. I didn't see it. Like I said, by the time I pulled her out of the way, there's nothing unusual.
You say somebody tried to pop her before. Maybe this slug was for her, too.
It's a possible.
So in other words, if something comes down, you're going to help us right away, right?
Absolutely.
That's all I'm asking for. Thank you.
Not you, ma'am. A few more questions, okie doke?
So how are you holding up, Mrs. Coffee, water. I'll try to get through this as fast as possible.
That's okay, Doctor.
What's that story?
You said someone tried to kill her. She might be right.
Hit the dead guy by mistake, huh?
I don't know. Maybe. Maybe not.
This ain't gonna take much longer, okay?
How well did you know the victim?
We just met.
I mean, no disrespect or nothing like that, but you just met this guy. How come you're so broken up over a stranger?
Maybe you see people get killed all day. I don't. I'll never forget this. Poor man.
I've seen that look before. That polygraph look.
She knew the guy. I don't know why she's saying she didn't.
She probably set him up.
That's not it. It's something. She's not telling these guys everything she knows.
Like?
There was a relationship there, her and the guy.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know what else. I will find out. What are you saying, I got no class?
Yeah. That woman today with you and Veter, who is she?
Since 1972, she's been Julia Brown. Before that, she didn't exist.
How old do you figure?
I don't know. Early, mid-40s.
So that'd make her about 20 back then. Maybe she was living at home, going to college.
I scanned her entire life. She's got no high school diploma, no college degree, nothing. No trace.
Then maybe she was part of the counterculture.
Sore subject, huh?
Never had any use for them then, and I still don't. Their idea of democracy was to riot and burn the flag, and they turned the country against its own.
So maybe in 72, she goes straight, you know, gets respectable.
That bunch will never be respectable to me. We send guys off to fight a war, and then those that survive it and come home get treated like crap. Wasn't right.
Maybe she was one of them. One of the counterculture bunch. Something happened, a riot, a bombing. Somebody gets hurt. She goes on the lam by going straight.
That'd explain the 1972 birth date for a 45-year-old woman.
Right. She gets a social security number, starts paying taxes, hides in plain sight.
Makes sense. Hiding from what?
Or who? I wasn't the only one checking into her background. There were inquiry tracks all over her record.
So, what do you do now?
I don't know. I guess just ask Julia Brown. It's not what I asked you. Who were you before, and what are you hiding from now?
I'm not going to talk about it. It doesn't have anything to do with what happened.
Was your friend part of it, too? Or was he just in the way? Was this supposed to be you? Talk to me.
I've told you everything I can. If it's not enough, I can't help it. But I'm not lying to you, Mr. Swift. I am scared.
Or something? Jealous boyfriend? Lady, look at me. Somebody went to a lot of trouble here.
The tenant in the apartment before me had a drug problem.
What kind of drug problem?
I don't know. I just heard it from the neighbors. She owed money to some dealers, they said.
She has a name?
No. She has one, but I don't know what it is.
How long did she live here?
For a while. She moved out about a year ago, I think.
But this isn't homicide.
Because Paul recognized the address from talking to that lady the other day about the dead guy. And we figured the two were connected. It's simple.
I always admired you for your quick mind there.
Yeah, good. Now tell me, what happened over here?
What happened?
No, I could see what happened. Looks like a bomb hit this joint. And you didn't even mess up your hair. How come?
Because I kept my head down.
Oh, so in other words, you didn't see nothing again, right?
No, I wish I did.
Ma'am, I wouldn't worry about it being drug dealers.
Why not?
Dealers shoot each other. They tend not to shoot their customers. It's a business.
I'll talk to you a little later.
Yo, hey, Phantom, let me know where you're going to be next time so I could be on the other side of town. You are dangerous, kid. Look at this place.
Hey, Vita.
Think we're stupid, don't you?
Who?
Cops, ex-cops. Think we'll just swallow anything you say? Today's fairy tale?
What if I told you it was true?
What if I told you every time you tell me something's true, I have a hard time believing it?
What are you talking about?
You're lying. What am I protecting you from? Someone else or your own lies?
Not protecting me from anything anymore. I made a mistake having you help me. I can take care of myself.
You know, I had your jacket dusted for fingerprints.
And?
You were right. She's not who she says she is. The prints belong to an open FBI wanted file. Very wanted. She's one of the four radicals that hit this Commonwealth Bank back in, I think it was...
1972?
1972.
Oh. What happened after the bank job?
Three of them escaped, took on new identities.
And the fourth?
Oh, he was killed. He was the one driving a getaway car, crashed and burned.
Hiding her past. It was a whole other life. That's why she can't go to the cops.
She's a wanted felon. You know I can't ignore this.
Oh, yeah, I know. I'll turn her in. I just like to know what's going on with this first.
Don't compromise me on this one, Mac. This is serious.
I won't. Come on. Just need a little time.
All right.
The bank and two men died. I can't protect you from that. The truth, right now.
There was Roddy, TJ, me, and Leo. Leo had been there in Vietnam. He'd seen the maimings, the body counts. He almost died himself.
A landmine shattered his skull. He used to say it was the government's own fault that he was so hard-headed, because their doctors put him back together with a metal plate in his skull.
Why rob a bank?
Well, we weren't going to rob it. We were going to shut it down. It was Leo's idea. Shine a media spotlight on the money machine. It was Leo's idea. Shine a media spotlight on the money machine. The war profiteers and their evil money. An act of conscience, not violence.
Yeah, well, it didn't turn out that way. What happened?
Leo had a gun. None of us knew it. He took the money, and the guard came after him. Leo shot him. Leo was driving the car. The police were chasing us. He made us get out. He said it was all his fault. He tried to get away down an alley, but it was blocked or something. So he came back out of it, and the car stalled. And the cops started shooting. It all just blew up. Caught fire. Leo was trapped in there, and he burned to death. I loved him. We all did. Remember I told you that a man was watching me? He's just down the block, to my left.
Back to your apartment. Like nothing's wrong. And I'll talk to you later.
Problem?
No, sir. Sergeant Raleigh. 2-7, huh?
That's right. Off duty.
You're making my client nervous, which makes me a little nervous.
Then you do have a problem, but it's your problem, so deal with it.
You see, it's not that easy, because I know what you're doing, trying to find the people responsible for your father's death in 72.
I know who is responsible, and your client is one of them. They shot him down in that bank like he was nothing. He's my dad. I plan to have my satisfaction.
Then you have a problem, because I'll stop you.
How? I haven't done anything illegal. You think differently? Sue me. Otherwise, stay out of my face, Swift.
You know who I am.
I know everything about you, man.
And you know I'll do everything it takes.
Time you got here.
Sorry.
I did a background check on your shooting victim.
Don't tell me. He didn't exist before 72.
Right. Same with his partner in crime. This guy TJ. But get this. He kept his old name. I found him. I know where he is.
Outstanding. Let me ask you something. What do you know about this guy, Uni Sergeant out of the 2-7 named Raleigh?
Oh, Raleigh. Oh, this guy, he transferred in a couple of months ago. I don't know. He's kind of strange. He spends all his time alone. He got no friends. I don't know about this guy, man.
Tell me about it. I just ran into him.
Yeah? You and Raleigh. That's funny. He spends all his time surfing the internet looking for the guy who killed his father. He's obsessed with it.
Well, he found him. It's the same group. The dead guy, TJ, my client.
Oh, so you think Raleigh tried to take a whack at you and your client?
Yeah, it's looking like it.
Oh, that's great. That's great. I didn't turn in a wanted felon when I knew she was wanted. Now we got a rogue cop on a rampage, and she's involved. Coffin's gonna kill me, man.
Not if we can head this off. Now, where's this guy TJ?
He's down at this jazz club in the village called Opus One.
go check him out.
I got a bad feeling about this, Mac.
Come on.
Door's locked. Closed. I guess we'll come back later.
Of course it's closed. It's a jazz club in the middle of the afternoon. While we're here.
While we're here, what?
Come on.
What are you doing?
Hey, quit looking, then we're out of here.
What, I got arrested to get you out of here or something?
What's the big deal?
Breaking and entering, that's what. I'm out of here, man.
Come on, wait a minute. I got it.
Come on. Venus, man. Nope. If I see a rat in here, I'm gone.
Asking about me. You want to know about me? Ask me.
I know all I want to know about you, man.
What is it, you snitch for your friend Swift? Helping him protect a known fugitive?
You're just as bad as everybody says you are, right? Put it down, man.
You and your friend can help the murdering bitch all you want. But I'll get her.
All right.
She's mine.
All right, Raleigh. Walk away from me now.
Yeah, chill, bro.
What the hell are you two doing?
Raleigh's got a big mouth, Sergeant. Don't listen to him.
My son acts like a loose cannon. I have to live with that. But you, Detective Patterson, you're still a cop, for crying out loud.
It's not as bad as it sounds, Sergeant.
Just how bad is it?
I gotta go. I checked Raleigh out. He's got a jacket, that one. Departmental warnings, one suspension. This is all before he came to the 27th.
Telling you, my man's a live wire with a short fuse.
Yeah, not to mention he's got a bad attitude. I gotta hand it to him, though. He's got this remarkable record of extracting full confessions from suspects, especially when he's left alone with them.
I'm sure it's his personality.
Sure it is. Sounds a lot like you.
You got a home address?
You got me skating on quicksand here, man.
Look, if Raleigh's the guy, this thing's almost over. Just give it up.
Lose it, okay?
Those people are dying.
Whoever it is deserves a medal.
I like you for it. You got a motive and a history of violence.
What happened to you, Swift? They say you were a good cop.
Same as you. I let something personal get in the way.
Those killers are more than just personal with me. Getting them, that's all I care about.
Why now, Raleigh? Why wait all this time?
You expect a confession, huh? Not from me. I didn't kill those guys. I didn't try to kill that woman. I don't know who did. But I think it's a hell of a good idea.
Your client back in for questioning?
Yeah, I knew they would.
She says that the killer might be after you, not her.
What? She's been living lies so long she can't stop.
I got more bad news for you. Raleigh, he may be a human hand grenade with a vendetta, but this guy has got alibis. I don't think he killed anybody, no matter how bad he wanted to.
Who alibied him?
Other cops, duty roster.
So maybe it's bogus.
I don't think so.
Everything leads to Raleigh. Should have known it was too neat.
Well, whoever this guy is, he's damn good.
He's gotta be to stay ahead of Raleigh. Not to mention staying ahead of me.
Well, who else has a motive?
Right, who? Where do you usually find clues?
At the scene of the crime.
TJ, me, and Leo. Leo had a gun. Leo was driving the car. Police were chasing us. Leo made us get out, said it was all his fault. Tried to get away down an alley, but it was blocked or something, so he came back out of it, and the car stalled. The cops started shooting.
Exactly how Leo planned it.
So why now? Why would
Because Raleigh found you. If even one of you had been arrested, there would have been four pictures on the front page of the Times. The three who went underground and the one who died in the car. Leo was afraid he'd be recognized by someone who knows him now. I had to do.
Yeah, but you put other people in jeopardy. Patterson's career, my credibility in the department.
Neither one worth more than a life, even if she is a fugitive.
Well, I can't argue with that. But I think you could have found another way. You gotta bring her in.
I already told Patterson I would.
Well, do it fast, Mac, before she gets killed. And you gotta make this thing right with Raleigh.
The guy's nothing but trouble.
True, but you should consider the source of his trouble. He grew up without a father. With an obsession. One I would think that any son would understand.
All right. I'll square myself with Raleigh.
Then I'd be happy to help him.
Hall of Records.
Let's see.
27. 75, 74, 72.
January 72. Help yourself.
January. I will. Thank you. Right over here. Let's see what we got here. Everything we need. Yes. Body was burnt to a cinder.
No facial features, no scars, no prints.
How much heat is generated by a gas tank explosion?
Enough to melt steel.
The dog tags weren't found on the body. They were found a few feet away on the ground.
Yeah?
So the dog tags could only ID the body if they weren't on it. Piece of metal like this was on the body, would have melted.
He burned up. I watched it. The whole car was in flames.
No. Somebody burned, but it wasn't Leo. He faked his own death. He got a hold of his military records. He had the same training that I did. Classified expert in weapons and explosives.
The newspaper said it was Leo in the car.
90% of the body was burned. No features, no fingerprints. But he made sure that the dog tags weren't on the body so that they would be found.
How can you be so sure?
You told me he had a metal plate in his head, right? The cops got the corpse out of the car before the skull burned. The x-rays showed no metal plate. The body was a plant.
How could he do that? We would have known.
You said he tried to escape down an alley, right? And he was out of sight for a couple of minutes. That's where he switched the body, which was probably in the trunk all along. If I'm Leo, I've got the car already rigged with explosives. What he was trained to do. Nothing left to chance.
That means he probably killed whoever it was in the car? I just can't believe Leo would do that.
Whose idea was it to hit the bank?
It was Leo's.
Played you all for suckers, beginning to end.
Me most of all.
To stop this guy Leo, we have to get to him before he gets to you, which means you have to know that I'm on your side.
I do, I guess.
It also means you have to tell me everything you know.
I have, I swear.
No, you haven't. Leo found you. You led him to Roddy and TJ, but he got to you first. How? Who have you told about yourself?
No one.
What about me?
Except you.
Who else?
Guy on the internet.
What guy?
I told you I talked to people on the internet in chat rooms. At first he seemed so sympathetic. He said we all have things in our past that we ran from. He told me about his childhood.
And you told him what?
Little bits of my life. I thought I was safe. All he knew was my screen name. Then he said he wanted to meet.
That was Leo. Don't you get it? He became who you wanted him to be, again.
And I got scared. I said we couldn't meet. I changed my screen name, but he found me again. Finally, he backed off.
No, he didn't. He closed in. You told him just enough so he could find you.
Okay. So how do we find him?
We send him an invitation.
Log on.
Dear old acquaint, I'm frightened. Remember what I told you? Someone's after me, trying to kill me. You're the only one I can turn to. I need your help. Will you meet me?
Nothing more to
Why
say.
Would I come all the way down here to waste your time like this?
I got no time for this, man. Look,
I'd be wasting my time here,
just
man.
Just give me a break. I got places to go, all right? Okay, what is this?
Just listen to him for a minute, all right?
You tell him about Leo?
Yeah, I told him he don't believe it.
Come here, believe it. The guy who pulled the trigger on your father is still alive. You should be part of taking him down.
But in exchange for what? The woman walks?
No, Swift has already talked to her. She's going to surrender. Don't worry about that.
I walk her in. That's what I want.
You got a plan?
Yeah. It's already happening. You want in?
What about the woman? Is she part of it?
Yes, she is. But you'll be safe. You'll get your collar.
Blink, don't breathe.
Put your hands on your head and get down on your knees. Do it!
All right, just don't shoot. It's just a little joke. That's all it is. Guy paid me $100 to put a scare into his old lady. That's all.
Set up.
That's all it is.
Cuff him.
Don't shoot. Right, don't shoot.
Mom, I didn't want to believe it. How could you do it?
I needed the money.
We believed in you. The money didn't matter. It wasn't important.
It was important to me. It was my beginning. And you were easy marks.
Poor Roddy and TJ.
They had to go. So do you. I got too much at stake now. Too many people know me. I can't afford to be recognized. Tied to the robbery.
I loved you, Leo. You said you loved me.
What can I say? I lied. Mom.
Exactly what he wants you to do.
I'm in a very agreeable mood.
There's so much more to life than just putting it on a page.
Word on the street is some cat's got a Jones for you.
Swift, trust me, he's dead.